guys, welcome back. I wasn't going to do a video on this, and I decided I would. So you're going to catch it already in progress. What I've done to this point is I took stripper and stripped the top of this table and kind of got the legs a little bit, but there needs to be more cleanup done. I've taken the legs off and marked them so I know which locations they go back in. I just have to clean them up. This is stripper. This is a cherry table. It's over 100 years old. It's not something I want to see going to the dump. I built a table for someone, and maybe I'll try and put a quick clip of that in here too.
It's a trestle table, farm style kitchen table.
And they were replacing this table, and they were just going to throw it out. So I said I would take it, save it for the house. With the stain that was originally on it, I was thinking it would be potentially maple or cherry, but I determined it's going to be cherry, it's not maple. And that makes me even more happy that I saved it. I was told that it's been repaired a number of times. And obviously, these aren't 100 years old. They're lag bolts. I won't replace these. I'll use these. When I took the legs out, you can see there's nails in here. When I had the table set up, it was fairly sturdy. It's got a center leg and there's two leaves in it. So the center leg goes in here. I'm glad I got it. Show you a little bit more here.
So you can see that there's nails in here as well. And those would have likely been original. To allow for some movement, there's gaps here, but the nails would have kept it from coming up and down. It just allowed movement this way. And then somebody added these drywall screws in there. We'll see how sturdy it is when I get it up, whether it really needs these or not. And if it ends up needing a screw, I'll put in and some wood screws a little more appropriate for the time. Or maybe I'll use new ones even, since some of this other hardware's getting a little bit. Instead of wasting good old ones on something that's already got new parts. You can see the saw marks in here. Just another little indicator of age. You know, if this was made in the factory 20 years ago, you wouldn't have that. This hardware here, this action here, is the locking mechanism when you don't have the leaves in. It's kind of neat. I don't know what this is, but it's obviously from a factory. You know, a furniture company. It's not probably made in somebody's wood shop. And this is what the wood looks like when it's been stripped. Now, somebody, and you can see on the bottom of the tabletop, stained it a very dark, probably a dark walnut or an espresso color at some point. According to the previous owners, this has been in the family the entire time, which doesn't surprise me. You know, people like the fads go from all natural to we want the reddish cherry or mahogany look to let's go to walnut and darker, and you know, depending on what era the table was refinished in, that's the way it worked out. But you can see the darker stain under here in particular compared to the tabletop, which to me is very interesting. Somebody took the time when they stained to stain both sides of the leaves, but not the underside of the table. When we fix this, I'm not going to strip the undersides. We're going to leave it. I'm not going to invest that much time and energy. I want to flip this fairly quickly. Don't have room to store it. The other reason they got rid of it, and this is a reason the previous owner said they didn't think I would want it because it was shattered, that this leaf was shattered. So I had this splintered vision in my mind of a leaf that was dropped. So it's just got a crack in here. And then after stripping it and using water to clean everything off, this crack showed up. So from swelling, and which is going to be easy enough to fix as well. I'm sure it's part of this. It just wasn't as visible. This one's slightly offset. We'll get some glue in there once it dries good and get that back the way it should be. But I think it's going to be a beautiful table. So if you're interested and want to come along for this resurrection of this old table, I'm posting them. I'm going to try to make the videos fairly short. This will probably be the longest or about the longest of all the videos. I'm going to keep them under 10 minutes. And it's not a how-to. It's just kind of what I'm going to do to get this table turned and sold in a relatively short period of time. I'd like to have it out of here within, the 22nd, 3rd of August, 3 weeks. And I got a lot of other stuff to do, so I can only work on it for short periods of time. So, that's the goal. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next one.